Hi everyone, so good news, I've got a job offer, like finally. If you have watched my previous video, you will know that I recently changed up my job hunt strategy and started exploring contract roles as well. So there has been quite a few companies approached me for an interview since then, and I have completed a take-home assessment for one of them. And the company has actually come back to me to ask me for a second round of interview, roughly 1 week since I submitted my application. The second interview was on Zoom. It started with us discussing about my past experience, the project I have worked on, and how confident I am with different tech stack. Then it came the live coding session. So the interviewer asked me to pull out my take-home assessment. So if you remember, in my previous video, I mentioned that I found an issue in the take-home assessment, that the backend wasn't linking well with the front end and it's not a fully functioned app. So it turns out that I was right, because the interviewer told me that you should have noticed that the API is missing from the app, please add it in now. So it turns out that they purposely left out the API from the take-home assessment so that I can implement it live in front of them. So for the live coding session, they gave me 30 minutes to build the API, linking the front end and the back end. And they told me that I can use any resources I need, be it Google search, documentation, or even Stack Overflow. So I was pretty surprised at how realistic he is. As you know, that some of the live coding session can be rather unrealistic, or I would say irrelevant to your day-to-day job. So then I asked him, can I use ChatGPT? Okay, I didn't, I was just joking. Although I would say that I was indeed thinking about that in my mind. Anyway, so I quickly added the API in the backend and then updated the front end to call the API and then fetch the data and display the data in the front end. So the app was working fine and I completed it within the 30 minutes. So the interviewer seems to be pretty pleased with my work and they shows more interest in me after seeing that I have successfully completed the live coding. After that, they continue with some non-technical questions like, what kind of work environment do you prefer, remote or office? So I answered them hybrid because I knew from the recruiters that they are currently on hybrid arrangement. So I think that's a safe answer. So before wrapping up, they asked if I have any question for them. So I asked about the projects that they are currently working on and they gave me a detailed explanation of each of the projects they have. So by this time, I have a pretty good feeling that they might want me, because I know that interviewers generally wouldn't want to spend extra time on applicants that they know they wouldn't want. So I make sure that I summarize what they have told me, the project statuses, the tech stack, project owner, and the difficulties that they have faced in the projects, to show that I was paying attention and was very interested in their projects. And I think it works. The interviewer seems to be pretty happy with me. After the interview, I grabbed my lunch, and by the time I finished it, my recruiters called me and told me that they would like to offer me a 12 months contract. Honestly, I didn't accept the offer immediately. I told my recruiter that I would like to think about it for a while. I always have permanent role with bonuses, stock options, more leave days, and flexible working hours. So this contract role definitely is not that appealing to me. But less than an hour of thinking about it, I called the recruiters and told her that I would like to accept the offer. And here is why. Firstly, the job market is pretty bad right now. I'm not sure if I can get a better offer if I turn this one down. Secondly, the offer is pretty decent, especially the companies nowadays seems to be lowballing software engineer. Thirdly, which I think is the most important part, is that I think there's plenty of opportunity for me to learn new skills here. And that's very valuable. Lastly, I had a good feeling about the team. I could sense the team dynamic during the interview, And the fact that they confirmed my offer so quickly also shows that they are pretty serious in hiring me. That said, even though I have a job offer now, I don't quite feel like I'm out of unemployment yet. It's a 12-month contract, and if let's say they don't convert or renew me, I'll be job hunting again in 12 months' time. My plan is to use this time as a kind of like a buffer for me to pick up new skills, maybe get an AWS certificate or dive deeper into AI, since that's like the hottest topic in the town now. We will see. Drop a comment below and let me know what skills you think would be good for a software engineer to pick up nowadays and not to be replaced by AI. So I shall see you in the next one. Bye bye.